Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together in this lesson. We are going to have biology form 1, lesson 1, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on classification 2 and the subtopic kingdom Animalia. Remember there are 5 kingdoms now, but in this lesson we are going to look at kingdom Animalia. But before we start our lesson, can have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to give the characteristics of the arthropods and the crustaceans. So you're welcome. Under the kingdom Animalia, we are having a phylum Arthropoda. But actually, before we go to the phylum Arthropoda, I want to give you some general characteristics of kingdom Animalia. One, most of kingdom Animalia, they are eukaryotic and multicellular. Their cells have no cell walls, that is the members. And the third characteristic is that all are heterotrophic. Remember, these are the characteristics, the general characteristics of kingdom Animalia before we get into the phylum Arthropoda. Another characteristic of kingdom Animalia is that most produce sexually, while a few reproduce asexually. And then one of the last general characteristics of Animalia is that most show locomotion, but a few are sessile. However, in this case, sessile, we mean that they do not move. Kingdom Animalia comprises up to 9 phyla. That's why, but in this chapter, we are going, but in this lesson, actually, we are going to look at phyla Arthropoda. And as you can see, we have got general characteristics of the of its members, whereby one, members of phylum Arthropoda have jointed appendages, hence the name Arthropoda. Let us have a diagrammatic presentation of the arthropods. Actually, as you can see from our screen, one of the examples of these arthropods is that is the centipede. We have the spider, we have the scorpion, we have the millipede, and we also have the praying mantis. So as I am going through the general characteristics, you are going to observe the general characteristics from the diagram that we are seeing on our screens. So let us go to now the general characteristics. One, we have said that members of this phylum have jointed appendages, and this one is clearly observed on this diagram that is which are on our screens. They possess many paired appendages which are specialized for various functions. Two, the body is covered with a hardened exoskeleton made of chitin. The exoskeleton provides services for muscle attachment. It is shed at intervals to allow for increase in size. This condition is referred to as molting. As you can see from our diagram, for example, the millipede, the body is covered with this exoskeleton, which is very hard. Another characteristic is that they are segmented. That is, their bodies have got segments. They have got several segments. Our fourth characteristic is that the body of most of them is divided into the head, thorax, and abdomen. In some, the head and thorax are fused to form a cephalothorax. So let us take the example of the centipede. It is not possible for you to differentiate the head and the thorax of the centipede, or rather the millipede. So it is conjoined into one thing, whereby that what you are calling that one thing in quotes is what we are calling the cephalothorax. The members of this phylum are bilaterally symmetrical. What we mean by them being bilaterally symmetrical is that when you get something like, let us say, a razor blade, and you cut, or you cut them, they can be cut into two parts which resemble one another. Another characteristic is that they have an open circulatory system where blood flows in open cavities. Remember, we have got the closed circulatory system and also open, that is closed and the open. But members of this one normally have the open circulatory system. The head is well developed, having eyes. We have the head also has got sensory structures and a fairly well developed brain. Another characteristic of the arthropods is that gaseous exchange is through the tracheal system, which opens through spiracles to the outside Another characteristic is that reproduction is mainly sexual with internal fertilization, because the sexes are both separate. So that is to mean it's possible for you to get a male millipede and a female one, also a male spider and a female one. So their sexes are separated. The phylum, this phylum is divided into five main classes, whereby the classes include the crustaceans, the chylopoda, we have the diplopoda, arachnida, and insecta. But now the division into this, actually it is based on some characteristics such as one, the number of limbs are present and the number of the antennae. Sorry. We have got number of body parts. So now we are going to look at the class crustaceans, which is under the phylum Arthropoda. We can have examples of this actually include the shrimp. We can have the crab. We also have the lobster. We also have the starfish. So these are the examples actually of members of the crustaceans. So we can now look at the general characteristics of these crustaceans. One, we can say the head and the thorax are fused to form the cephalothorax, which is often protected by a surface. So as I am stating the characteristics, it is important that you look at the diagram such that you'll be able to identify those characteristics. The second is that they have two pairs of antennae. You can see that one is from the lobster. They have between around 5 and 20 pairs of limbs, which are modified different functions. For example, the functions can be for locomotion, feeding, and defense. The limbs are on the cephalothorax and the abdomen. Four, they have a pair of compound eyes. Five, we have three pairs of mouth parts consisting of one pair of mandibles and two pairs of the maxillae. Actually, the gaseous exchange is through the gills. That is another characteristic. Whereby you are saying that the gaseous exchange is through the gills. Most crustaceans are marine, but some live in fresh water. A few are found in most places on land. Aquatic forms inhabit the shores, rock surfaces, around water plants, and the living open waters. Actually, most of the crustaceans are free living, but a few barnacles are parasitic. Ecologically, they are important as primary consumers in aquatic ecosystems. What you mean by this is that actually these crustaceans, remember, they live in the waters, so they consume some of the either the dangerous sea waters which you might find there. Having done and said that, you can have the following activity whereby you are required to write five general characteristics of members of phylum Arthropoda. And for more information in this lesson, you can refer to our KLB Secondary Biology Student Book 3, which is the 4th edition, that is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For this and more, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Let us subscribe.